Yo, yo, what it do, YouTube crew, friends and family. Thank you all so much for tuning in today. I'm Rose. You're watching Rose Reacts. Today we got another good one. This is Elders React to Lil Wayne. Love Lil Wayne. He's a GOAT in my book. Bro, make sure you drop a like on this video. Them likes, I fucking cherish them. They my babies right there. I appreciate them likes you give me. And make sure you sub if you aren't already. Make sure you turn on those post noties so you know when I fucking upload, and tell your friends to come and watch us, bro, because we're fucking lit. All right, without further ado, let's hop into it.
These guys would have more fans if they cleaned up the verbiage.
The block is hot. Yeah, he's absolutely fantastic.
I like her. Yeah.
Wayne. I didn't know that Lil Wayne and Kendrick Lamar did a joint.
The Carter.
Did a joint? She's real old school.
Such a language nowadays.
Right. We get down, bro.
She left it on. They started French kissing, so he didn't see more. She let him in. They stopped on the couch. Music up loud with his head in the clouds. Turn his
wow.
Shit on and I scared a piss out.
Incredible story. Amazing.
Pissing off, put the gun to his frown.
Oh boy, what a great lyric.
Fuck around, cut you with your pants down.
Different, man.
So in conclusion, cause you like rappers that's killing their
oh, my.
Kind of,
oh, my.
Mona Lisa.
Yeah.
Mona Lisa.
It's because they painted a picture with the story.
I'm surprised he's still Lil. I would think by now he might be big. Or
he's huge. Bigger win. Oh, around the corner and a U-turn sign looking like a frown.
He sees death around the corner.
And I see death around the corner and then you turn.
Ooh, God, it's like predicting.
Do they have to have that kind of language?
Bro, it's lit, dog.
It's flat. I don't like his voice.
Yes. As good as advertising. On a triple extension on my
mother. These guys would have more fans if they cleaned up the verbiage.
Bro.
Don't know why.
Don't know why. Wow. They're all surprised. This guy is awesome.
This is the one that everyone was talking about, that this happened before he was murdered. I don't mean in terms of someone telling him something, but did he have such an intuitive nature? And you kind of wonder if that was the case.
What?
5, 4, 3, 2, I let one go.
I don't understand what she just said.
I'm a cutthroat. You're a tough guy.
Hey, sing that shit. It's a joke. You're a tough guy, bro. That's a joke.
Yo, where the love go? 5, 4, 3, 2, where the ones go? It's a show.
What a great beat and rhythm.
It's nice.
Just imagine if you had some different words to that.
It's a good song. Where the love go?
There you go.
5, 4, 3, 2, I let one go.
Yeah, this I can get into the beat and the rhythm.
Well, your lyrics aren't my favorite, but somehow they go.
They're a vibe. Yeah, because that's Wayne. Hey.
Hell no.
Young kids, listen to this. Hell no. Nation. Free speech is one thing, but this is ridiculous.
So those songs that's very true. No, that's very, they're very, very right. But that shit is lit. That shit's fire.
I've heard of Lil Wayne, but I didn't know he had released a new album.
Up next, we're going to show you a few more of his older hits. Mm. We're going to start with his debut single that was released back in 1999.
Oh, really old. Previous century.
Super
that's extraordinary to achieve success at anything for almost 20 years. Straight off the black
bag, in my hand.
Oh no.
Oh, this is much more hardcore.
I don't want you to. Don't do it. Don't win me over.
She's flexing in front of me, dog. She definitely. She don't like Wayne. She's just.
The block is hot. Yeah.
You don't really show. Oh, yeah. Do you really like him, though? I want to know.
Because that shit would be so lit. That's like an experience. I say he's so sweet. I want to lick the rapper.
So I let her lick the rapper. She licked me like a lollipop.
Oh,
hey,
nice.
Sing that shit.
A little play on homonyms. Hey,
this is
bottles in the club.
More gentle.
Shawty wanna hump. Oh, I like to touch your lovely lady.
He's so catchy.
He's catchy as fuck. He's good.
Really showing
pussy in my mouth. Had me lost for words.
In the industry, perhaps.
Like
where are the songs about the man? You know, let's objectify the man. Let's see the man shaking.
You gotta go with Hot Girl Summer, no? I think, I don't even know.
About making love.
Oh, yeah. Yup. That's what every song's about.
Okay, so you gotta sell yourself to the devil to be successful? No, that was horrible.
He's very good
at
beats.
Song.
A lot of people out there don't really know the lyrics to songs. They immediately gravitate to the beat, the rhythm, and that can get them going without them even knowing what is saying.
Whoa. Look at me when I'm talking to you. You looking at me, but I'm looking through you. You. I see the blood in your eyes. I see the love in disguise.
Yeah,
what's that?
Hit it.
First
of all,
these fucking people don't know shit about music.
Screw loose.
A lot of they need to learn. They need to like comprehend this right? Shit.
No, I ain't giving it no big up.
Well, he needed Bruno Mars' help to do this. Makes it better.
They don't need Bruno Mars' help. This is fucking the blood on the game.
Very scary.
They're hating on my boy
Wayne. A lot better. A lot better lyrics.
Talking to each other again.
Oh, that's interesting. Now, here's the most interesting thing about that
in my mind.
He is reflecting on his own being.
Right.
And there's no inappropriate language in that one.
You're gonna feel a pinch.
You didn't hear the full song. I don't know if they heard the full song. You might have just heard a clip. No, who knows?
Oh, OMG. OMG.
It'll last forever.
I certainly like this.
This
is better. This is good.
This is extraordinary subject matter.
Is she crying?
No, through the glass. It looks like he's incarcerated. Yeah, he's incarcerated.
Like you never had a love. You like it? That's a good song, bro.
I mean, come on. How can we can't do all the rest of music like this?
You can see it. The kid is growing.
Beautiful.
Beautiful. Absolutely amazing. I'm stunned. Oh, my gosh.
That is extraordinary of him to take on that intense subject matter. That's a deeply moving video.
This surprises me because I have not heard.
I love Wayne, bro. Wayne is a GOAT, bro. I just love Wayne, bro.
Lil Wayne's latest album, The Carter 5, experienced several delays as a result of contract disputes between his label
and the label about all that, bro.
Birdman, despite being pushed back for 4 years, the album debuted at the number one spot last week.
Of course.
Wow.
That's Wayne.
Poetic justice for him.
What do you think of the fact that he's been gone for so long? You know, rap has changed. Artists come and go. Yet this album was still able to reach you.
Bro, he's built such a name for himself. He could be gone forever and motherfucker will still be number one. Wayne is the GOAT, bro.
He's like a poet and he speaks for a certain generation.
He came back
too soon. He speaks for everyone. I'm just kidding.
Wayne's some messages out there to these young people.
If you maintain your style rather than changing to the time, I think you always have that group to follow you to push you to that level of number one.
Yeah.
Like we mentioned, due to a lawsuit with his label, Wayne was unable to release a proper studio album for 4 years.
That's a long time.
The dispute between Wayne and his label was very public, with fans pleading with his label to let him release more music. Growing up, did you hear this type of argument between labels and artists? Was this something kind of labels try to keep hidden?
Fuck no, they don't care about that kind of shit. They don't even know what a label is.
Artists can speak directly to their fans now through social media.
They talk shit about my boy Wayne.
Keep them updated on everything that's going on. Make them start being sympathetic towards the issue.
Yep,
social
yep.
media is probably a tool that you can use to keep people involved.
It's the whole Apple thing with the Beatles. And there was a lot of, that's when I think we started kind of going,
I don't know, I'm not that old.
I have
no clue.
Best example I remember in my time was the Jackson 5. They were completely restricted to the songs that were given to them.
So after the album was released, Uproar was quickly seen by fans as one of the easier tracks to dance to. This brought an influx of videos to social media that features fans dancing to the track, creating a new viral dance craze called the hashtag Uproar Challenge that Lil Wayne himself participated in.
Yeah, like Drake's challenge.
We're seeing more and more artists embrace social media in this way.
Oh, but she like knows Drake. She probably like Drake. He is the same type of language and talk all the same type of shit. Wayne is just a little bit more explicit. But she probably like Drake. She probably like Drake a lot.
That's very smart marketing. Because if you can draw people in, you know, and she tells her friend, and that friend tells four friends. Boom, you've got more popular.
Streak is kind of cool, huh?
When you add a dance challenge on to a new song, more people are going to buy that song.
Mm-hmm.
So it will result in sales.
Yes, it will.
It can reach much
and
broader audience.
And I'm sure that motherfucker got a lot.
Not just a certain group. You're talking about instantly, internationally, simultaneously, the people responding to it. You know, I think that is incredible way to present anything,
right.
Not just music.
Yeah. So finally, we showed you a variety of Lil Wayne's music, from rapping about women, money, and success, to seeing a more personal side to him, seeing both explicit and more personal songs. Does this make you want to check out his rap music at all?
Nah, I ain't interested.
Since we've been examining rap songs here, I do listen a little more carefully.
I will give another shot.
Hey. Matters not to me.
Would I sit down and specifically go after it to listen to? No.
No, that's just not my style of music.
I would probably press play on the ones where I like the lyrics more.
Absolutely, it makes me want to check out his rap music. This
gentleman
is extraordinary, and I feel richer for having experienced
this lady. I low key want to get high with that chick, because I bet you would have. Oh my god. This weed has opened my eyes to some extraordinary things in life. Put on that Wayne. Woo! I guarantee you that would be great. Bro, this was a great video, y'all. I mean, it sucks that they hated on my dog Wayne and shit, but like, hey, fuck it. It's for some people and it's for others, you know what I mean? Or it's for some people and it's not for some people. I got that a little bit mixed up. I'm fucking, I don't know, bro. But you guys, make sure you drop a like on this video. Like I said, I appreciate the fuck out of them. Comment down below if you want me to react to a video that you like. Subscribe for more videos, turn on those post noties so you know when I upload, and tell your friends to come and watch these videos with us, alright? Until next time, y'all, thank y'all for hanging out. Rosae out. Hey.